This is a very interesting feature which we are going to learn is advanced filter. In advanced filter, suppose you want to filter out this data on the basis of certain criteria, and my criteria are I want to filter out data for item where the item contains the word pen. So it can be pencil, it can be a pen, or we have a pen set over here. So I'll just add Control Shift L. And you'll see that we have three items, pen, pen set and pencil, which contains the word pen. This, and also along with that, my second criteria is that the total cost should be greater than equal to 250. So this is how I want to extract the data, filter out my data. So how we can do this? It's very simple. You do not need this filter over here. What we need is we need to write the criteria separately in different cells over here. Just make sure that the column headings are exactly similar to what you have written here. Like the item should be exactly same, it should have the exact same spelling. It should not make any spelling errors. Also the total which I have over here, I have exactly copy pasted it here simply, and I've written my criteria as pen, and the total cost should be greater than equal to 250. Now in pen, when I've written the criteria, I've used the wildcards. Now what are wildcards? Wildcards are basically when you search for a, when you're searching for a word or any cell and you do not have the complete cell, you do not have the complete text, then you, what you use are the wildcards, which will let Excel know that there is something missing before pen and there is something missing after pen in the words which you are looking for. So we have asterisks as wildcards, we use question marks. So here I'm using asterisks. This means, so I can avoid using this first asterisk because we do not have anything before pen, pencil or pen set. So it you can avoid that, but it's fine even if you use any wildcard before this word. And we are using one wildcard, which is an asterisk after this particular word. So this is my criteria. Obviously you can add more than two criteria. I've just added for simplicity two criteria over here. You can add more criteria, like region can be east, or you can add it for the date column. So you can do that as well. Now this is done. Next thing is I want to extract the filtered out data in my new sheet, which is the filtered data sheet over here. So what I'll do is, it's very simple. First of all, go to your filtered data sheet. Click on the cell where you want to extract the data. Go to the data tab. In the sort and filter section, click on the advanced. And here, instead of filter the list in place, you want to copy it to another location, because this is my new location where I want to copy my data. So I'll click on this. The list range which I'll deal with is in my advanced filter sheet. So I'll just select the entire table. So I'll just select the entire table. The criteria range again is in the advanced filter sheet. So I'll just select the entire criteria like this. It's very simple. And the place where you want to copy your data to. So I want to copy my data here. I'll just click on A1 and OK. So this is how I've copied the data. As you can see, let me just adjust the columns. So I've added the those data only whose item is pen, pencil or pen set, anything which contains the word pen, and the amount column which is greater than 250. So it's very interesting, very easy to use advanced filter. But the next thing which I want to show you all in this particular video only is that, suppose I do not want to extract all the columns. I just want specific columns to be extracted, and it can be those columns which does not have your criteria. So that can also be done. Suppose I want to extract column region, rep and only the units. So these are the three columns which I want to extract. Now these columns does not contain my criteria, which is item and total, and it's perfectly fine. You can work this out also. Again, going back to my filter data, I'll just click on the place wherever you want to get your data. I want region, so I'll just click on region, rep and the units. I'll just select these, copy these and paste it over here. These are the three columns which I want. The next thing is, again, to go to the data tab, in the sort and filter section, click on the advanced. Again, your list range will be the entire table over here. So I'll just select the entire table. Criteria again remains the same, which is there in my advanced filter sheet. I'll just select this and I'll have to obviously click on copy to another location. The location being this, but instead now I have to select these three columns. Now why I have to select these three? Because I just want to extract these three columns and I do not want to extract all the columns. So I'll just select these three and I'll click on OK. The moment you click on OK, you see you have all the three columns. You can just go through the data and you can see that it's exactly similar. You have exactly similar columns. This means you are successfully, you have extracted out those data which have item containing word pen and the total cost which is greater than 250. Although you have just extracted three columns in which you do not have the criteria itself. Thank you. This is it for advanced filter.